In this video, we will study about foreign trade and integration of markets. In the past, foreign trade was the only channel which connected countries. And in the ancient time, we can see that there were many trade routes which connected India and Southeast Asia. And these trade routes were also connected to eastern countries and the western countries. We have studied about silk routes and all. So this foreign trade was done only through this trade routes. Now we also studied that it was the interest in the trade which brought many of the trading companies to India. So many of the foreign trading companies like East India Company, English East India Company, Dutch East India Company, French East India Company, all these companies came to India for trading. So now let us see what are the basic functions of this foreign trade. So we can specially say that there are 3 to 4 basic functions of the foreign trade. The first and the foremost function of basic trade is with foreign trade, the domestic markets can create, or the industries can create an opportunity. It will create an opportunity for the producers to reach beyond the domestic market. Domestic market means the market of their own country. When a thing is produced and foreign trade occurs, the thing can be sold not only in their own market but also in the markets of other countries. So that is why producers can sell their produce not only in their own markets located within their country, but they can also sell it, or they can also compete in the markets located in other countries. So their products will compete with the product of the other country, and whichsoever is better will survive. For buyers also this foreign trade is very useful, because imports of the goods produced from other countries is one way to expand the choice of goods beyond what is domestically produced. That means usually what is produced in our country, we get only that one. But if there is foreign trade, the things produced by other countries will also come to Indian markets, and we can buy other goods also. We will have a greater choice. Let us prove this with an example. Like China found that Indian toys were very costly. So Chinese started selling plastic toys to India. So when China started selling plastic toys to India, the Indian buyers found that Chinese toys are cheaply available and they are of new designs. So the Indian buyers started buying more and more Chinese toys. And within few years, many of the Indian toy shops were replaced by Chinese toys. So the advantage for China by expanding its business to India was it created an opportunity for the producer means the Chinese producer, to reach beyond the domestic market. That means now the things are sold not only in the Chinese market, which is their domestic market. Apart from that, it can be sold in India also. So they have got an opportunity to reach beyond their domestic market. Second, now these producers, that means the Chinese toy producers, can sell their products in the markets which are located away from their country, and they can compete with the products made in India. So when competition was there between Indian toys and Chinese toys, the Chinese toys proved to be better. So they could compete. Then as we know, Indian buyers were happy because they got a variety of choices. They can now get Chinese toys also or Indian toys also. So in this way, the basic functions of foreign trade were fulfilled by the Chinese producers. Now, usually the opening of trade within countries, it helps the goods to travel from one market to another market. Then the buyers also get choice in the market, and the prices tends to be equal between the markets, and the products which are sold at a particular price in one market, the other people also try to sell it in the same price. And competition occurs between these products in the market. Though these places are very far away from each other, but even then they can compete in the market with their prices and the quality of the product. So in this way we can conclude that foreign trade results in connecting the markets or integration of the markets in different countries. So foreign trade is helpful because it can connect different countries in the